I think the most important thing to remember is that AI is us. AI is our history. AI is based on data. To get that enormous amount of data, it has to mine our histories. Our history is marked by systematic discrimination and bias. Because it's marked by that, our AI is going to be as well. We like to think that technologies are neutral, they're objective, they're somehow separate from society. It's clearly not true in the case of AI. Real biases of the world get hidden because we make those assumptions about technology. So now we think, okay, a judge is biased, but if the AI is the one who's making the bail decision, somehow it's making objective decisions when actually it's based on historical data based on judges. My concern is that it's going to get normalized. It's going to be part of our everyday lives. And that's one of the problems. The promises sound extraordinary. They sound wonderful. But the realities are usually a lot more mundane. We don't have a lot of information about the data on which these technologies are trained, the algorithms that are used. These are often private companies. And those private companies want to maintain their intellectual property because of their proprietary data. And so they don't want to give up information about how their technology works. Technologies that are structurally biased, that are not adequately tested in, people of color, people with disabilities, LGBTQ people, and that's the place where it's of most concern. So I think we need to start there. If we want to minimize the harm to those communities, what kind of regulatory infrastructure do we need? To me, that is the greatest concern.
I do think the public should be a little bit worried about AI. But I think there tends to be sort of this caricature of are we creating sentient machines? And I think that what we need to be worried about are things that are already here, rather than things that might exist way far in the future. And what is already here are social networks that polarize us, or generative models that create misinformation, that convince people of untruths. Honestly, I worry about civil war because we're so polarized and cannot speak to each other anymore. That, I think, can incite violence. It can incite civil unrest. I think we should think deeply about how do we regulate these things. Less so about robots with consciousness. I think that's not the right place now to spend our worry.
There is no switch out there. For example, can we pull the switch on fossil fuels? And that is less of a technology question and more of a political and economical and even ethical issue. We will have to face when deciding whether we can pull the switch on AI once it starts touching on every aspect of our lives. As computer scientists, we're very eager to code away any problems that we see. We think that we can code away pandemics, we think that we can code away social inequity. Sometimes it's important to take a step back and realize that computer science cannot solve absolutely everything.
My area of research is in autonomous agents, making computers that make decisions in a variety of contexts. An area that I study is the impact of AI in finance, particularly algorithmic trading in financial markets. Over the last 15 years, has gone from very little activity to really constituting the major part of financial trading. And what we do in our research is we study the fundamental techniques to make them better. We try to analyze what the implications are of having AI systems doing these things in the real world. It's really an imperative for public research. As AI controls more of our environment, we should be concerned about the implications of that. One example is how has the social media shaping of news affected our politics, our social discourse? It's not necessarily specific to features of the AI technology, but just the fact an algorithm controlling all of this information. In the financial applications that I study, to what extent will decision-making about lending, say, by machine learning algorithms, change who gets loans and who doesn't? We need to always be concerned about these kinds of changes. The rules and regulations that were designed for situations where people are making decisions may no longer really be completely applicable when it's machines making the decisions. We live in a world where our rules and regulations are built assuming that humans are making decisions, and that's not always going to be the case.